The upper airway management adjuncts and suction station will have a patient that is in need of airway management due to respiratory compromise or respiratory arrest. You'll begin by taking a moment to examine the equipment available to you, as well as the airway mannequin you are using for this station. You will begin by telling the preceptor you have completed your inspection of your equipment, and then you will take or verbalize body substance isolation precautions. You will select an appropriately sized oropharyngeal airway for the patient, measuring the airway from the corner of the mouth to the tip of the ear. You will then insert the airway using a tongue blade or other appropriate device to bring the tongue forward while you insert the airway. The examiner will advise at this point that the patient is gagging and becoming conscious. You will remove the oropharyngeal airway. You will then be advised that the patient needs to have their airway suctioned. You will turn on and prepare the suction device. You will then assure that the suction device is applying mechanical suction, and then you will insert the suction tip without having the suction applied, applying the suction only as you remove the suction tip from the oro or nasopharynx. The examiner will then advise you to insert a nasopharyngeal airway. You will select an appropriately sized airway by measuring the airway from the corner of the nose to the tip of the ear. After you've measured the airway, you will verbalize that you are lubricating the nasal airway before fully inserting the airway with the bevel facing toward the septum. There are a few critical fail points to be aware of. If you fail to take or verbalize body substance isolation precautions, if you fail to obtain a patent airway either with the oropharyngeal or the nasopharyngeal airway, if you did not demonstrate an acceptable suction technique, or if you inserted the adjunct in a manner dangerous to the patient, each of these would be a critical fail point for this station.